and welcome to FDTV. We are back again with another episode of our daily football show. I'm your host Ali, joined with my fellow co-host Jawad. Jawad, how are you doing today?
I'm doing great, Ali. Not a lot going on in the world of football, but there is still something to talk about. The transfers are keeping us up and running. Hey, so make sure to hit the thumbs up button for all the latest news. And hey, subscribe as well.
So big news coming from AC Milan and Real Madrid. Right now, the reports are very strong in suggesting that Alessio Romagnoli and Isco are going to be a part of a swap deal for both giants of the football game. And do you see it having any impact on AC Milan?
Isco is a player that I'm torn on, I must admit. But it's a big enough name that if he comes in, he might be able to make an impact. I remember the days when we were signing the likes of Torres from Chelsea and hoping that he'd have the same impact that he had at Liverpool, but he wasn't able to do that. Now, this transfer makes me think of the same transfer again. Now, there are three players that are very, very big names, Coutinho, Isco, and James Rodriguez, which would make me think of the same Torres transfer to AC Milan and make me think that this might not be bound for success. Now, Ziyech, on the other side of things, is an exciting prospect that I might be up for. Now, but the concepts of this transfer is a straight swap between Romagnoli and Isco. I feel like that's a good swap. That's a very good deal for both of the clubs involved. Now, Real Madrid obviously need an upgrade in defense. Romagnoli is not a good fit for AC Milan as of right now. The way our defensive setup is in place does not really help the style of play that Romagnoli has. He's a player with very high ceiling. Even though he's getting up there in age, he should be in the prime of his career. He's not able to get to that level just because the system that he plays in does not suit him. He was probably our best defender for the last 5 or 6 years. Now, that got absurd by when Fikayo Tomori and Simon Kier came in. Both of the players are actually outperforming Romagnoli, so he's out of favor. Whether he starts or not is in question as well. And considering he's the captain of AC Milan, makes this whole debacle a little bit not good for press, not good for the club as well. So if Romagnoli swaps the red and black of AC Milan for the all whites of Real Madrid, I think that's a good move for him. Now, Isco, on the other hand, is valued about 17 million. Whether that's a good move for AC Milan is in question as well. But the reason I think is going to be a good move is because we have a player, a little known player from the graduation from Manchester City all the way to Real Madrid, and that's Brahim Diaz. Now, if Isco and Diaz are able to play in the same number 10 role, they should be able to really play off against each other. Now, both of them are not going to be playing at the same time. I'm not saying that. But if he's able to learn, that's Diaz. If he's able to learn against what Isco has to offer, and if they can play interchangeably between a few games for Diaz and a few games for Isco, that's a good number 10 position for AC Milan. Both players are very good on the ball. Both players do possess some magic on the ball as well. So it's a deal which might not be making headlines, but I think I'm all for it. Are you for it or not?
I think Isco is past his peak. I know it's an absurd thing to say considering he's only 29. But Isco, if I look at last season, 900 minutes, 26 appearances, 17 of them were off the bench. And out of those 17, 11 were in the last 15 minutes of the football game. So he was used as a sporadic squad player at Real Madrid. So a big name who has fallen off completely, in my opinion. Only 2 assists in those 900 minutes he managed. So that is a big warning sign for AC Milan. Now, that also leads me to the way Milan play. If I look at Milan last season with Hakan Çalhanoğlu, even though he was not the quickest player on the pitch, the transitions were very fast from midfield to attack due to his ball-playing abilities. Now, Isco is more of a ball carrier. He likes to dribble between the spaces and take the ball very near to the final third, then release it to a wide man or a striker. So that is where the problem lies. Stefano Pioli might need to restructure his attacking side of things a little bit if Isco is going to be preferred in the number 10 role over Brahim Diaz. So that is a problem where I see AC Milan might be struggling a bit.
Thank you so much for watching another video of FDTV.
It's been great to have you joining us. Again, make sure to leave a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel. Every single subscription helps.
It motivates to put out more football content on a daily basis. Until then, see you next time. FDTV out.